Today we're taking aim at hair dryers. And if you rely on this styling tool for a good hair day, then it helps to know how it gets the job done. So, put away the fancy gadgets because everything you need to uncover the secrets of the hair dryer are right here. As Agent Zero, you're taking one of these babies apart to decode what manufacturers mean when they say ceramic heating elements, motors, ionic generators, tourmaline, and watts. Whether you're gathering intelligence or doing the teardown yourself, girl, you've got this. For this operation, all you'll need is an old or broken hairdryer and a screwdriver that dismantles your particular model. For this, I'm using a security Torx, but in most models, you can get away with a Phillips or a flathead. And make sure your hairdryer is unplugged or risk electrocution. Shocking, positively shocking. Much like pumping jam into a jelly donut, modern hairdryers are made of injection molded plastic. Yum. Plastic is light, durable, and great at keeping the heat focused on your hair instead of your hands. There are three common types: polypropylene, polycarbonate, and ABS. How uncommon. This one's made of polyamide nylon. That's what pantyhose are made of. Now that you've uncovered the type of plastic, you'll know how to recycle it properly instead of just throwing it away. This is where things heat up. Here is the heating element. See these coiled or wavy wires? They're made of nichrome. That's a smooth combination of nickel and chromium. The more coils and more wires equals more electricity and more heat. Selecting the low or high settings fires up enough wires to hit the right temperature. This is the same heating technology that can be found in your toaster. Could this be why hairdryer manufacturing giant Connery also owns small culinary appliance maker Cuisinart? Ceramics, it's not for just holding your caviar, but is used to evenly distribute the heat created by the nichrome wires. Expecting to see it as a heating element? Ugh, too obvious. Manufacturers take the more clandestine approach of coating it onto the heated wires. Want to bypass the heating element completely? Meet the cool shot button. One click disables the heater by cutting off power to the wires. Hydrogen bonds in the hair shaft reform, locking your style into place. All thanks to Bond, hydrogen bond. Now Mr. Bond might have his Aston Martin, but this girl runs off an electric motor that rotates the fan and allows heated airflow to reach your hair. There are three types of motors: DC, AC, and brushless DC motors. DC motors are light, low cost, and easily fit in the palm of your hand. Marketed as lightweight and travel, these motors are perfect for global espionage or a weekend getaway. Though inexpensive, even luxury models like the T3 Lux 2i use them when weight is a priority. The downside, the motor's moving parts fail after a few hundred hours. AC motors like the one we just found can make hair dryers heavier and cost a little more. So why do we use them as a weapon to defeat unruly hair? Because they have longer lifespans. That's why they're better suited for salon settings where hair dryers run all day, and probably why your hairstylist has such toned arms. Brushless DC motors are the best of both worlds. Lightweight with 7 times the lifespan of an AC motor. The minus is the price tag, because replacing moving parts with fancy electronics can be quite costly. Right now, we're seeing these motors show up in luxury models like the Connery 3Q. While this may not be an option for Ms. MD Pockets, if you want a hairdryer that's lightweight and has a very long life, then spending some hard-earned shillings on this motor could be the right choice for you. An ionic generator sounds like the device of an evil arch nemesis. but it's actually used to reduce static electricity, which can cause hair-raising results. Look at the front of the heating element and you'll see an exposed needle or tiny brush. An electrical field forms around the tip, charging the air with negative ions. In theory, this neutralizes the charge in your hair, reducing frizz and making it more manageable. Another ally in the fight against static is tourmaline. Advertisers market it as a semi-precious gemstone, but in a hairdryer, it's actually industrial-grade black tourmaline, pulverized into a fine powder and coated on the inner barrel. Not exactly the sort of bling you'd expect to wear as a ring. Like the quartz in a wristwatch, ions are produced when heat or pressure is applied. But will it make a difference in your hairdryer? Reliable scientific evidence is surprisingly hard to come by because it depends on the concentration of tourmaline, the amount of ions produced, and how close the hairdryer is to your hair. Sounds like we need a little more reconnaissance work to unearth the facts. So what's a watt? It's the amount of power that flows through the cord when the hairdryer is on. Hairdryers often state the number of watts on the box or body, but it can be a bit deceiving because most hairdryers today are already between 1700 and 2000 watts. Use anything higher and risk popping a fuse. While spas might work best in the dark, a little light is necessary when it comes to styling your hair. Want a better measurement for comparing the effectiveness of a hairdryer? Ask manufacturers for more meaningful measurements like heat and airflow. That'll tell you how good a model really is at drying hair. Well, Agent Zero, your cool confidence and calm has allowed you to solve some modern day hairdryer mysteries. A better understanding of a hairdryer's parts will also serve as an advantage on your next assignment, buying one in a store. Because your most advanced weapon is your brain. Besides, what were you expecting? An exploding pen?